Hello, good day everyone. Welcome to our new topic, and I will be introducing a new topic this time, which is the treasury management. First of all, I just want to thank you, ayan, sa pagnood and for participating in the discussion questions in the past videos that I have uploaded, and also thank you for asking questions. I really appreciate it. I know that you're being curious and you're really studying well. Ayan, especially sa kung ano mang course yung tinitake nyo ngayon. So, ayan. So today, I will introduce treasury management to you. This course or this subject is quite related to the banking and financial institutions that I have discussed in the past videos. Ayan, and why? Kasi treasury management or cash management is one of the roles or one of the functions, isa sa ginagawa ng mga banks and non-banking institution, lalo na dito sa Philippines. So yun. And today, I am going to introduce to you the concept of treasury. What is the importance of having a treasurer or a treasury management service? And also, what are the functions of a treasury management and the roles ng isang treasurer? So I know, di ba, ang treasurer or pagiging ingat yaman is one of the, kahit bata ka pa lang or nasa elementary ka pa lang, meron na nito sa mga officers natin. So what is really the role of a treasurer? And then I will also have a bonus lesson, okay, later I will be discussing that. So let's start. Okay, at the end of this lesson, I am expecting and I am really hoping that you would understand the meaning and importance of treasury management. And then I'm hoping that you are able to discuss the functions of the treasurer and the overall function of treasury management. And this is my bonus lesson, with which is the basic rules for dealing with money. So I pray na we will be able to understand, hindi naman ito yung lahat ng rule, but these are some of the basics na pwede mong i-apply whenever you are or whatever organization you are in. Okay, so let's start. Ayan, lesson 1. Okay, these are our lessons for today. So let's start with lesson 1, or what is treasury management? Okay, so treasury management, ayan, this is a management system, okay, that aims to optimize a company's liquidity. Okay, again, let's review what liquidity is. Liquidity, parang magiging liquid yung, when you say liquid yung pera mo, available yung pera mo whenever or wherever you need it. Okay, so for example, sa bangko, gusto mong maging liquid yung pera mo, so mag-ask ka for, halimbawa, savings account, tapos may ATM. So, anywhere you are, kapag kinailangan mo yung pera mo, you want it to be liquid. You want it right away. So, yun. So, that's liquidity. So, si treasury management, it ensures company's liquidity. So, the money is available whenever or wherever the company is, while also mitigating its financial, operational, and reputational risk. When we say mitigate, nalilessen. So, we will lessen the risk in the finance, aspect, operation, and the reputation. Okay. So, in the proceeding lessons, I will be discussing different risks na kinakaharap ng isang management. So, yun. So, sa treasury management, imagine, di ba, it will i-ensure niya na available ang company resources. At the same time, it will lessen the risk na meron ng isang company or mararanasan ng isang company. Next is, treasury management also is the corporate handling of all financial matters, the generation of external and internal funds for business. O, diba? Sila, basta related sa pera, sa kanila yun. Kung saan manggagaling ang pera, either through external funding or external financing. Kung naaalala nyo, sa banking and financial institution, we differentiated both of them. Tapos, or internal financing, management of currencies sa ano na to, as sa isang bansa. Okay, management of currencies, cash flows, complex strategies, policies, and procedures sa corporate finance. So, yun. So, lahat ng ito, okay, it's all part of the treasury management. So, to simply put, Treasury management is a management of all financial affairs of the business. Okay, and even a country, kung meron tayong Bureau of Treasury or Department of Treasury, sila yung bahala sa lahat ng financial affairs natin. Such as, ayan, raising funds, where are we going to source our funds, currency management, cash flows, and various strategies and procedures of a corporate finance. Now, let's proceed to the functions of treasury management. So, ano ba ang ginagawa talaga ng treasury management? So, treasury management aims to ensure that adequate cash is available with the organization during the outflow of funds. Further, ayan, si treasury management, it also contributes to optimum utilization of funds, and it makes sure that there are no unutilized funds kept in the firm for a very long term. So later, I will discuss more of this, but if you will see on this picture, and these are the primary functions of treasury, cash management, liquidity maintenance, availability of funds, deployment, your optimum utilization of resources, and risk management. Okay, as you can see, this is parang cycle, or they are interrelated. Okay, they are connected to each other. Okay, so let's see how are they connected to each other. First one, okay, the first function is cash management. Okay, treasury or cash management. So basically, ayan, sila ang nag-manage ng cash sa isang company, lahat ng kaperahan. Okay, it ensures that there are effective collection, ayan, and payment system in the organization, whatever organization it is. For example, kahit government organization, so they will ensure na, okay, yung lahat ng, halimbawa, SSS, so lahat ng collections from collections nila ng organization or ng sangay na ito ng government, kailangan ma-ensure ng treasury management na effective ito. And even the payment system, for example, sa BIR, di ba? So, they have to ensure that whatever we, kung paano yung way, sistema ng pagbabayad could be effective, they will be the one who will think of the regulations about that. Next is, halimbawa, non-government naman. You are a, halimbawa, an NGO kayo. So, syempre, there are donations. So, how are you going to think of an effective collection of your donations? And payment system, halimbawa naman, co-op kayo, so meron kayong mga members, and how are they going to pay you naman? So, yun. So, anywhere or kahit anumang organization yung kinabibilangan mo, whether it's a bank, a business organization or not, treasury management exists or should exist, and you have to ensure, it ensures that yung collection and your payment system is effective and efficient. So yun, so that's cash management. Next is the liquidity management. Okay, so what is liquidity management naman? Liquidity management is, this is an optimum level of liquidity. Okay, so in a treasury management, optimum level of liquidity should be maintained in the business for the better and smooth functioning of the business. Syempre, di ba, again, when we say liquidity, your money is available whenever you need it. So, syempre, as a company, as an organization, you must be able to fulfill your financial obligation when they become due for payment. Okay, for example, you're renting. So, dapat meron ka available na pera for that. For example, you're paying to your suppliers. Kailangan, syempre, halimbawa, kung ano na nga yan, parang every quarter na nga kayo nagbabayad, so dapat available na yung cash nun. Or every week, or every month, you're paying to your employees, di ba? Nagpapasahod ka, so dapat liquid yung pera nyo dyan. Meron dat kayong pamayan dyan, creditors, yung mga pinagkakautangan nyo, and whatever bill will do, okay? So, and to do so, ayan, para magkaroon ng mamanage ng maayos ang liquidity ng isang company, Cash Flow Analysis and Working Capital Management Act as the most important tool for treasury management. Syempre, para ma-achieve natin yung strategic goal ng isang company. Okay, so those are the first two. Okay, cash management. So remember that CM, cash management, and LM, liquidity management. Okay, now, the third function of the treasury management, okay, would be the availability of funds. Ito pinaka isa sa pinakamahalaga, 'di ba? The treasury manager must ensure that the funds are available with the organization in sufficient quantity. Okay, hindi lang basta available yung fund, but sapat yung available na fund, okay, in adequate quantity at the right time, kung kailan ito kailanganin, okay, neither be more nor less, hindi siya pwedeng sobrang dami naman, hindi naman siya pwedeng kulang na kulang talaga lalo, di ba? Yun, so para ma-fulfill natin yung day-to-day cash requirement, ayan, you have to check the availability of funds, okay, para syempre maging smooth yung pagpo-function ng isang enterprise. Further, ayan, timely availability of funds, ayan, yung kailangan at the right time available ito, it also smoothens the firm's operations. Syempre naman, di ba, hindi ka masyadong na-stress, ayan, hindi mo alam kung saan kakukuha ng pera. So, yun, it results in the certainty, resulting in the certainty as to the amount of inflows available with the company at a particular point in time. So, yun. So, in the availability of funds, kasama dito, nakapaloob dito na you're monitoring the inflows, okay, cash inflows, ibig sabihin yung mga pumapasok na pera, para ma-ready mo ito doon sa day-to-day cash requirements or operational expenses ng company. Next is the deployment of funds naman. So, yung isa, availability of funds, dito, deployment. Pagbibigay, pagkakalat ng funds, okay? Deployment of funds must be done in right quantity also, katulad ng availability of funds, such as the acquisition of fixed assets, purchase of raw material, payment of expenses like rent, salary, bills, interest, and so forth. Okay, now, anong role, okay, anong isa si task ng treasury manager? So, si treasury manager has to keep an eye on all receipts of funds and application thereof. Lahat ng na-receive, lahat ng ilalabas, kailangan yan alam ng treasury manager, okay? The funds must be available at the time of need. Ayan, sabi ko nga sa inyo, both yan, si availability tsaka si deployment of funds, the funds must be available in adequate quantity and at the right time. Okay? Yung pangangailangan natin into sa funds natin, it could be different for different companies or different organizations. Okay? And syempre, kung ano yung purpose, kung kailan nila ito gagamitin or kung bakit nila ito gagamitin. So, again, there is no parang generic strategy or, there is no parang, wala tayong masasabi na dapat every 30th of the month available ito, ganyan. Kasi iba-iba din naman ng pangangailangan at iba-iba ng sistema ang bawat negosyo. So, yun. So, the period may differ, yung pagkakatime, yung mga time na pangangailangan ng company compared to another company. It may differ to weeks or months. Ayan. Lalo na kung when you will mag-acquisit ka or you will do an acquisition of fixed assets. Ayan. Magkakaiba yan. So, yun. So, there are some companies that they are, kailangan talaga nila itong machine na to. So, kailangan nila maglabas ng pera, mag-deploy ng fund for that. Yung iba namang company, hindi naman nila kailangan ng ganitong machine, so hindi nila kailangan mag-deploy ng pera for that. So, yun. So, yung iba namang company, every 5th of the month and 20th of the month sila nagpapasweldo. Yung iba, 15-30. So, yun. So, we cannot say na dapat at ganitong moment, ganitong specific na date ay available na yung cash kasi magkakaiba nga tayo ng business system. So again, the third and the fourth function of treasury management is AFNDF, ayan, availability of funds and deployment of funds. For the fifth function of treasury management, so we have optimum utilization of resources or OUR. Okay, so it's ensuring the effective utilization of the firm's resources to reduce the operating costs and also prevent liquidity shortage in the coming time. So, syempre as part, okay, or ikaw yung nagmamanage ng treasury or finances ng isang negosyo, you have to make sure that the resources that you have are effectively and efficiently utilized para sa ikasasucess ng isang company. It is to reduce, ma-less natin ang cost due to errors o kaya yung mga operating costs dahil nakita nyo that there is an efficient way of doing something or doing this process. So yun, next is, ayan, that's the fifth one, and the next is risk management. So yan, so they are related. They manage financial risk to allow the enterprise to meet its financial obligations as they fall due and ensure predictable performance of the business. So risk management, so si treasury will tend to identify, measure, analyze, and manage risk in order to prevent, kahit hindi naman totally mawala, pero to prevent or malessen yung losses which can have a potential to affect the company's profitability and growth in any way. So that is why si treasury management is accountable for all types of risk that can influence the business entity. So sila, di ba, if nakapanood kayo ng BPO lessons ko, the risk management, so yun. So si treasury is one na merong part, okay, and accountable doon sa pagmamanage ng risk na yon. So further, ayan, si treasury management intends to maximize return on the funds available with the company by making such investments which have high return and low risk. Isa din ito sa function nila na sila ang magtitimbang doon sa investment na papasukin ng isang kumpanya. Syempre, dapat makita nila ano yung lesser yung risk pero mas malaki yung return. So yun. So those are the six functions. Again, six functions. The fifth one is the optimum utilization of resources and the RM or risk management. So again, these are the functions of the treasury management. Okay, first is the cash management. So, and then, so they have to manage the cash inflows and the outflows. Liquidity, sabi ko nga sa inyo, they are interrelated. So yun, so when you manage the cash, syempre, liquid yung cash mo, it is available whenever and wherever you want it. Then there's availability of funds, you can deploy your funds, ma-utilize mo efficiently and effectively yung resources mo, and with that, you can manage the risk, okay, of a company. So that, those are the functions of the treasury management. Now, what are the benefits? Okay, what is the importance of having a treasury management within the company? Okay, there are some companies na they have this department, treasury department or finance department, ganyan. But there are some companies na kumukuha sila, nag-outsource sila nito. So whatever it is, okay, so what is the importance of having that? Bakit importante ba na merong nagmamanage ng inyong kaperahan or ng inyong finances? So first one is, syempre, there will be time efficiency. Okay, so by implementing a treasury management system, businesses can streamline the payment process and reduce the time spent on payment authorization and initiation. So here, nagiging mabilis yung process, okay, kapag ka meron kayong parang clear na payment system or receiving or kapag lalabas ng pera, kapag clear yung process nyo na ganun, so mas nagiging efficient kayo sa paggamit ng inyong oras. So yun. So and also nagiging time efficient din, hindi lang dun sa mga payment system eh, kahit na dun sa pagmamanage nyo mismo ng inyong negosyo, hindi na kayo magkukonsume ng enough time na or ng extra time para makuha or para kumuha ng ganitong amount of fund or mag-isip, diba, ng kung saan siya kukuhain. So yun, kasi you already have your system, diba? So yun, so it is really a time saver to have a treasury management system. Next, benefit or importance ng treasury management, aside sa it is time saver, it is also cost saver, di ba? With access to various tools and resources, businesses can immediately detect the cost of cross-bank transactions and take better control of all the related fees. Again, hindi lang ito sa context ng sa banking, okay? So in kahit saang part or kahit saang transaction that you are going to have, mas nakaka-save ka ng mga, alam mo yun, mga operation cost, error costs, ayan, kasi syempre pag nagkamali kayo, that's a cost incurred in the company. So yun, so syempre having more control over the processes ng mga ganito, it also takes some of the guesswork out of financial planning, which reduces the likelihood of costly errors. So ito yung sinasabi ko kanina, na kesa magkamali kayo and then you're going to incur costs for the company. So if you are, kapag properly managed yung treasury nyo or yung cash nyo within the company, it's helpful. Okay, it can help you save in the other unrelated fees na ma-incur within the company. Okay, so again, time efficient or time efficiency, cost savings. Next is cash visibility. Okay, ano yun? Visible yung cash mo. Okay, a major perk that comes with treasury management is it allows, this is one of the major perks, okay, when you properly manage your treasury. Why? It allows decisions to be made in a positive way that affects a business's bottom line. So, bukod pa dito, again, cash visibility is your, makikita mo, okay, na-appreciate mo, kung halimbawa may business ka tapos properly managed ang treasury, nakikita mo na merong pinupuntahan, especially if you are just starting. Kung non-government organization naman, tapos halimbawa foundation kayo, so nakikita nyo dahil properly management ang treasury, nakikita nyo that you have a merong kinapupuntahan lahat ng ginagawa ninyo or lahat ng pagpapagal na or lahat ng sacrifices nyo. So yun, so that's one of the major perks of having or managing your treasury. And number four, last one, forecasting. Okay, forecasting, so reporting, parang ganon, and na-forecast mo na yung parating, okay, na kikita mo na if you're going to gain from it, lalo na kung negosyo ka, kikita ba kayo or hindi. So it allows the ability to obtain additional yield on investments, lower cost borrowing decisions, and pay down debt. Okay, when you are forecasting, kung meron kayong proper treasury management, may cash forecast kayo, mas nakikita nyo kung saan kayo pwede pang mag-invest, mas kumikita kayo, diba? And mas nakakapili kayo ngayon, halimbawa you're going to expand, tapos mas nakakapili kayo kung ano doon sa mga choices nyo. Halimbawa you're going to have an external funding, so hihiram ba kayo sa bangko, meron kayong iba't ibang choices, nakikita nyo kung ano yung lower cost, yung interest. So yun, nakakapili kayo ngayon, meron kayong option. So yun. So in addition na nag-offer ang treasury management ng cash visibility through forecasting methods, businesses can feel confident now, 'di ba, na yung na they will earn, okay, they will be confident enough to decide whether they will expand or not, or they will take this risk or not. Why? Kasi meron na kayong forecast. Okay? So and syempre nakita nyo or merong cash visibility na pinakita ang treasury. So again, these are the four benefits of treasury management. Again, hindi lang ito, okay, these are only four. And maybe if you have other opinion or you have other ideas about the benefits of having a treasury management, you can write it down on the comment section. Okay, so again, let's review. It is time efficient, and when your treasury is properly managed, it is a cost saver. Ayan, so mas makakatipid kayo, mas na lilimitahan yung error. Cash visibility, so mas nakikita nyo or mas nagkakaroon kayo ng picture kung saan napupunta and saan and worth it ba yung risk na gagawin nyo or ititake nyo, and forecasting, so mas nakikita nyo kung saan kayo mas mag-iinvest, saan kayo hihiram, paano kayo makakabayad dun sa mga hiniram nyo. Okay? So, those are the benefits of treasury management. So, we're done with our lessons 1, 2, and 3. Ayan, we discussed about what is treasury management, what are the functions of the treasury management, and what are the benefits or importance of it. So, in the next lesson or in the next video, I will be discussing the roles of an organization's treasurer and the bonus lesson, okay, na, which I will be discussing later. Okay, so see you in the next videos. Thank you.